Now let's speak about Alexander Emsley. He's the man who invented the Emsley count, originally known as the Coase count. And he was a mathematician and found something very interesting about the Faro shuffle. What if you could control the top card anywhere you want in the deck? For instance, you want to put the top card 12. What would you do? It's very easy. You alternate some in and out Faro shuffles. I'm going to show you how. So to put your top card in the 12th position, you have to move the top card 11 places. And 11 is your number. So you have 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and 32. And those numbers will help you to do that. 32 is too big, 16 is too big, 8 is good, because we're going to try to build 11 with those numbers. 11 is 8 plus, not 4, but 3 and 1. So you have 1, 0, 1, 1. And actually those are not 1 and zeros. Those are I's and O's. And this means that the sequence you're going to use is 1 in Faro shuffle, 1 out Faro shuffle, 1 in Faro shuffle, 1 in Faro shuffle, and that makes the top card in the 12th position. I hope you're gonna use this tool because it's a great tool for magicians. Here's another trick. You have a spectator who has a chosen card. You take that card and put it 26th in the deck. You take two jokers, put them on the top of the deck, ask the spectator to cut the deck because it's not going to change anything. Do one in Faro shuffle, and then guess what? The spectator's card is going to be sandwiched between the two jokers. Now imagine you put your cards in like the four aces in the first, 14th, 27th, and finally 40th position. You do two Faros, whatever in, out, or alternate, doesn't matter. What's going to happen? Those four aces are going to be on the top of the deck. Now, you take your four aces, put one at the 13th position, one at the 26th position, one at the 27th position, and the last one at the 40th position. You do two in Faro shuffles, and you get two aces on the top and two aces at the bottom. Finally, last but not least, imagine you write the name of a card on the side of the deck, do four out Faro shuffles, and you know you're halfway to getting the deck in the original order. You force that card and make it back at its place, and then in front of the spectator, who knows what her card is, you are going to do four more out Faro shuffles, and all the mumbo jumbo that was there is going slowly reveal her card. And I can tell you this is great. And this is great because Faro shuffle, nobody knows that it can be perfect. Nobody knows that you can alternate exactly all those cards. So that's why everything you do with Faro shuffle is so impressive for laymen. So I hope you have fun with this shuffle. Practice, enjoy it, and good magic. Bye bye.